We loved watching Love is Blind Brazil, but are you curious to know what happened to the cast after the camera stopped rolling?
Vai dar tudo certo.
Carolina and Hudson. Carolina and Hudson were quite the power couple on the show, but did their love ever truly last? As it turns out, yes. The couple's still married to this day.
O que valeu foi muito a experiência e o encontro.
Even a 3-year age gap couldn't stop their chemistry from blooming early on. Hudson stepped up to the plate, proving that her fierce personality and feminist ideals weren't too much for him. He matured while Carolina also met him in the middle.
Muito feliz, aliviada. De ter feito a escolha certa.
Compromise is a beautiful thing, people. In the end, the two ended up saying, I do. What's happened ever since that fateful day? Well, Carolina and Hudson have been blissfully living in holy matrimony in Sao Paulo, Brazil. Carolina is a successful attorney, while he is a fashion and lifestyle influencer. Hudson's career has seemed to pick up after the show, so it looks like he won't be financially relying on her anymore. He recently hit 100,000 followers on Instagram and posted the caption, "The word is gratitude for each follower, each message, and say how much I'm happy and how much I love you. They are making one of my biggest dreams come true. From the bottom of my heart, thank you." So it seems like he's still remaining humble and grateful for his recent achievements. We wish them all the best in the future. Diane. Even though Di and Rodrigo had a strong start, their love seemed to crumble as soon as their honeymoon ended. Di wanted more than just a superficial link, and Rodrigo seemed to be that. But their differences in terms of tidiness was a significant problem, and a lack of common ground also proved to be more significant. The two still follow each other on Instagram, so they both seem to be on good terms. As of today, Di still serves as a bank clerk. Even though she may not have found lasting love on the show, she doesn't regret the experience and is still grateful for all that she learned during her time on the show. On Instagram, she posted black and white photos of herself in a wedding dress and wrote in the caption, "Marriage is not always with the other. Sometimes it's with us, you know? In the process of participating in this unique opportunity that was the blind wedding, I rediscovered myself and found a girl who still dreams without taking her feet off the ground. I continue to believe that love is the strongest force that exists. And this romantic, solid, and incredible love that I talk so much about, I will never give up." So Di still believes in love and has not given up on one day finding the true one for her. We love that.
Oi, Cupido, me nota. Tô aqui, tô só te esperando.
Rodrigo. What about her ex Rodrigo, you may be wondering? Well, this was a great learning experience for him as well. He describes himself as an eccentric guy, so this unique dating experience proved to be just that. He posted a photo on Instagram of him and Di with the caption, "Next to a great man, there's always a great woman. For those who know me, you know that I'm a guy who lives to smile and see the good side of life. And for those who know me even more, they know that sometimes a smile doesn't mean happiness, but believing that life will always be the best for me. I want to thank all the women who are a part of my life. This crazy experience made me understand even more that half the world is a woman, and the other half was born of one. How sweet." So the two are still on great terms and are both thankful to have had one another in their lives. As for his career, Rodrigo is still a financial consultant as of now. Anna. We thought Anna and Cheyenne would really last, but that turned out to not be in the cards for the pair. The cracks culminated into a fight that had Anna leaving to stay at a hotel for the night. Anna at the time felt completely crushed by their breakup, saying on camera, "I got rid of a huge weight. I just want to be happy. Cheyenne from the pods is the love of my life. For that to move forward, it takes attitude. It takes effort. Now I will have to deal with this illusion that was never there." Aww.
Completamente. Anulado.
We felt so bad for her that she was hurting this deeply. Neither held back their true feelings at the altar, while saying no in front of their friends and family. Today, Anna is living a happy life as a model and mother, and is trying to soak up every moment with her daughter while she's still young. Cheyenne. After his breakup with Anna, Cheyenne is trying to stay present and focused when it comes to living day to day. He's still an entrepreneur and investor, and loves being surrounded by family, horses, and business more than anything else. He posted a photo of himself with his horse, with the caption writing, "What a connection, what energy, what purity." So it sounds like he's really connecting with more simplicity after stepping away from the craziness that is reality TV.
Com muitas coisas que eu nunca vivi na minha vida.
Cheyenne and Anna's post-breakup lives sound all happy and cute and everything, but of course there's still some new drama boiling over. Cheyenne got criticism on the show that he didn't do his share of the housework, And in response to this, he shared a video on his Instagram, where he plays with Anna's little daughter. The caption of the video, which has since been deleted, states, "No one in the world will accept that smile that God has given me." Anna did not like the fact that he was using her daughter to boost his good guy image. She clapped back on Twitter, tweeting, "Little spoiler, my daughter hates Cheyenne, so I don't want him using her image. The only good moments between them were what they saw, but all the participants were so proof that she didn't feel comfortable around him. Got it?"
Quer ficar comigo? Quer? Não?
So no, it's safe to say that the two probably aren't on good terms anymore, and are mainly just focusing on themselves at this point in time. It seems like it's for the best that these two split. Nanda and Thiago. We have to admit, Nanda and Thiago's relationship seemed rocky ever since she got confused between Thiago and McDavid in the pods. But things took an upward turn after they got back into the real world. The two lovebirds are still together. They had to overcome a few obstacles, of course. His upbringing and self-admitted sexist notions made him question several things. And Nanda had to learn not to point out the negatives in everything. After working everything out, Nanda decided to go with her gut and propose to him herself. Their tying the knot was a pleasant surprise, and they're still working things out every day. They still seem to be living in Sao Paulo, where she works as a beauty stylist and lifestyle influencer. And her partner is a commercial skydiver, model, and content creator. Judging by her Instagram, she loves spending quality time with her dog, while he loves taking risks when it comes to high adrenaline activities like skydiving. He posted a photo from their wedding day with the caption, "You knew me without masks, with a clean face. You knew my ways, my flaws, and my true essence." Aw, how sweet! It seems like they're really enjoying married life so far, and we're so glad they're a happy couple. Luana and Licio. These two are some of our favorites from the show. Even though they started as a love triangle between Carolina, they managed to straighten things up and nothing could tear the two apart. They never really had big fights, but Licio calmed Luana down whenever she got too feisty or in her head.
Eu sinto que Deus me deu melhor.
Luana and Licio both said "I do" at the altar, and admitted that because nothing is ever perfect, they wish to spend forever in their imperfect world. Luana gave advice to fans on her Instagram, writing, "All in good time. Never disbelieve in love. The secret is not in looking or waiting, but in allowing yourself." We think that's such good advice. They both seem very humble and surround themselves with close family and friends, and are grateful for everything this experience has taught them. The entrepreneur and psychotherapist are willing to work through it all, and that's what we think is going to make them truly last. What do you think about the couples, makeups, and breakups? Were you surprised that some of them lasted and others didn't? Let us know in the comments below. And like and subscribe to The Things Reality to stay up to date on the latest and greatest in reality TV news.